Hello again, Hayden Locke, Executive Director and CEO of Emmerson is with us here at Proactive Investors London. Great to have you in the studio.
Thanks
for coming in, Hayden.
Thank you very much.
So tell us then about Emmerson, what it does and why it exists.
Emmerson was a special purpose acquisition company that was listed 12 to 18 months ago with a specific task of acquiring a mining asset. We announced the acquisition of a mining asset in October of last year. Over the past 6 to 8 months, we've spent a lot of time completing that transaction, and recently went out to raise about £4.5 million to fund the future development of the project. We had some overwhelming demand, and so upscaled the size of the raise to £6 million, and we're just about to start trading again on the main market of the LSE.
So all going in the right direction. Tell us more about this project then.
So the assets that we acquired are some potash assets located in northern Morocco. So potash is used as an agricultural fertilizer primarily. And the reason we like these assets is potash as an industry is typically associated with astronomically high capital costs to get into production and very remote project locations. The benefit that we see in these projects in northern Morocco is number one, it looks like because they're very shallow, the access to the mineralization will be relatively cheap. And because Morocco has absolutely outstanding infrastructure, the infrastructure associated capital cost will be much, much lower. So we see the potential for a low capital cost development potash project, which is extremely rare.
And what's the demand like for potash?
So the demand has been growing slowly, and like all commodities, there was a little bit of a tail off sort of 2 years ago. But we've seen a strong recovery last year and certainly this year, and most of the large producers in the world expect record demand again this year of about between 64 and 66 million tonnes. So a strong future growth thematic across the fertiliser industry, supported by growing population. The UNFAO expects that we're going to have to produce 70% more food from 15% less arable land, and that means that using potash fertilisers and all of these other fertilisers is going to be absolutely imperative.
So it's shallow, so production costs relatively low, in that it's easy to get to. It's in Morocco, infrastructure good, but what about volumes? How much is there?
So we have a relatively large JORC compliant resource, which we announced as part of the prospectus, of about 311 million tonnes of potash at a grade of 10.2% K2O. So it is a significant resource. From our perspective, we believe it is a big enough resource to support a mine life of at least 20 years, so multi-decade, and certainly potential to grow that further with further exploration work.
Where would you like to be in a year from now?
We have a fairly well mapped out pathway of development, but really this is a development story, so we're going to be ticking off the technical milestones to assess the technical and economic viability of this. In 12 months' time, we'd like to have delivered a scoping study, certainly be well underway in our detailed and comprehensive metallurgical test work, and on our way to delivering a pre-feasibility study.
So investors should take a position because?
The valuation at this point in time is incredibly compelling for what we have. And we see a very clear accelerated development path in front of us that we intend to execute over the next 12 to 18 months.
Hayden Locke, great pleasure to talk to you. Come back and give us an update soon. Thank you.
Thanks, Polly.